Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's session we are going to solve the problems based on zeolite process. Zeolite is a process in which we convert hard water into soft water. But to convert that hard water into soft water, we need to add in certain chemicals and regenerate them as well. We'll see the quantities of the same by solving the numericals in today's session. Solve problems, zeolite process. The first one, hardness of 4,500 liters of water was removed completely by zeolite softener. This zeolite required 30 liters of 100 gram per liter of NaCl to regenerate. So what is given to us over here is 4,500 liters of water, that is the quantity of water. And the word zeolite is given to us, that means that we'll have to use the zeolite formulas over here, the reactions of zeolite as well, which requires 30 liters of 100 gram per liter of NaCl. So the values of NaCl are also given to us. What is there to calculate? Calculate the hardness of water. The overall hardness of water we need to calculate. Let's see the solution. Whenever we use the zeolite permeate method, we use the reaction of it. And the reaction is the regeneration reaction. That is CaZe, where Ze stands for zeolite, that is calcium zeolite, plus 2NaCl will give us Na2Ze, that is sodium zeolite, plus CaCl2. Let us see the balancing of this reaction. We have one calcium on the reactant side, one calcium on the product side. One zeolite on my reactant side, one zeolite on my product side. We have two NaCl, that means two sodiums on my reactant side, and I have Na2 on my product side. Two chlorines on my reactant side, 2Cl and Cl2 on my product side. That means this regeneration reaction is my balanced reaction. Whenever we talk about this regeneration reaction, we mean that twice of NaCl corresponds to my one of CaCl2, corresponds to CaCO3. Now why do we take CaCO3? Because whenever we are trying to find out the hardness of water, we always find it with respect to its CaCO3 equivalence. And that is the reason why this on my reactant side, that is 2NaCl, will correspond to this on my product side, which is CaCl2, which will eventually correspond to CaCO3. That means this NaCl, which is on my reactant side, will correspond to the CaCl2, which is on my product side, which will eventually correspond to my CaCO3. So over here, we are finding out the molecular weights of NaCl, CaCl2, and CaCO3. To find out the molecular weights, we'll have to add up the atomic weights. So atomic weight of Na is 23, Cl is 35.5. So when you add these up, you get it as 58.5. CaCl2, over here my Ca is 40, Cl2, my chlorine is twice, and that is the reason why we take 2 into 35.5. So when we multiply 2 into 35.5 and then we add it with 40, we get it as 111. So 111 is the molecular weight of CaCl2. Finally, moving on to CaCO3, over here the atomic weight of Ca is again 40, atomic weight of carbon is 12. And oxygen over here is 3, that means we have 3 into 16. So when we do 3 into 16 plus 12 plus 40, we finally get it as 100. That means 100 is the molecular weight of CaCO3. We know that twice into 58.5, now this 58.5 represents my NaCl. So twice of NaCl will correspond to CaCl2, which represents 111 grams. Will correspond to CaCO3, which represents 100 grams. Now, quantity of NaCl in regeneration is 30 into 100, which is 3000 grams of NaCl. Thus, 2 into 58.5 grams of NaCl will correspond to 100 grams of CaCO3. Then 3000 grams of NaCl will correspond to 3000 into 100 upon 2 into 58.5 grams. Now from where did we get this? This is from cross multiplication. If I have 2 into 58.5 corresponding to 100, then 3000 will correspond to question mark. That means 3000 into 100 divided by 2 into 58.5. That's how we got 3000 into 100 divided by 2 into 58.5. 2 into 58.5 is 117, so we get it as 3000 into 100 divided by 117. And when you calculate this, it boils down to 2564.102 grams of CaCO3. Converting the grams into mgs, that is 2564.102 of milligrams of CaCO3. 4500 liters of water, now this is already given to us in the question. 4500 liters of hard water correspond to 2564.102 milligrams of CaCO3. Then 1 liter of hard water will correspond to how much? Again, this is the same kind of cross multiplication wherein you will do 1 into 2564.102 divided by 4500. 1 into this entire number will be this number. And that's the reason why 1 into 2564102 will be 2564102 and you divide it by 4500. When you calculate this, you get the answer as 56.98 ppm. Therefore, the total hardness we get over here is 56.98 ppm. Question 2. Classify the following impurities into temporary, permanent and non-hardness causing impurities. CaHCO3 twice. MgSO4, CaCl2, CO2, HCl, MgHCO3 twice, CaSO4 and NaCl. The first part of the question says that we have to classify these impurities into either temporary or permanent or non-hardness causing impurities. The second question says, how many grams of CaCl2 dissolved per liter gives 150 ppm of hardness? Let us see the solution of the same. So in the solution, we'll first see the salts causing the respective hardness. Now, whenever I'm talking about temporary hardness, I will only talk about the carbonates and the bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium. When I'm talking about the permanent hardness, I talk about sulfides and chlorides of calcium and magnesium. So in temporary hardness over here, I will use CaHCO3 twice because it's a bicarbonate of calcium. I will also use MgHCO3 twice because it's a bicarbonate of magnesium. Apart from that, let us see the permanent impurities over here. The permanent impurities are MgSO4, the sulfates of magnesium, CaCl2, the chlorides of calcium, and CaSO4, the sulfates of calcium. All of these come under my permanent hardness. Finally, we have CO2, HCl and NaCl. When we look at CO2, HCl or NaCl, neither of them are either carbonates or bicarbonates, and that is the reason why they will not come under temporary hardness. Neither of them are sulfates or chlorides of calcium and magnesium, and that is the reason why they will not come under permanent hardness. And that's the reason why they come under non-hardness causing agents. Over here, we complete the first part of the question. Now we move on to solving the second part of it. To calculate grams of CaCl2 per liter to give 150 ppm hardness, we'll go through the reaction over here. CaCO3 plus 2HCl giving me CaCl2 plus H2O plus CO2. Now this CO2 has an upward arrow, that means it will go away and mix with the atmosphere. Let us see the balancing of this reaction over here. We have one calcium on the reactant side, one calcium on the product side. We have one carbon on the reactant side, one carbon on the product side. We have two hydrogens on my reactant side. We have two hydrogens on my product side. We have two chlorines on my reactant side, two chlorines on my product side. So this is again my balanced equation over here. The molecular weight over here, 100 is of 1 mole. The molecular weight over here is 111 for 1 mole. So this 100 corresponds to the molecular weight of CaCO3 and 111 corresponds to the molecular weight of CaCl2. If 1 gram of CaCO3 regenerates 1.1 gram, now why have I taken 1 gram over here? Because this 100 can be written as 1 gram And this 111 can be written as 1.11 grams of CaCl2, which when dissolved in 1 liter water gives 1 ppm of hardness. Thus, to get 150 ppm of hardness, CaCO3 should be taken 150 grams. CaCO3 should be taken as 150 grams, whereas CaCl2 should be taken as 166.5 grams. Gives 150 ppm of hardness. Thus, 1 gram of CaCO3 per liter corresponds to 100 milligrams per 1000 ml, which is equals to 1 ppm. Question 3. The hardness of 50,000 liters of a sample of water was removed by passing it through a zeolite softener. When they use the word zeolite, we'll have to use the zeolite reactions and the formulas. The softener required 200 liters of NaCl solution containing 125 gram per liter of NaCl for regeneration. So over here we have been given 200 liters of NaCl solutions, and we have also been given 125 gram per liter of NaCl for regeneration. Calculate the hardness of the sample of water. So again, over here we'll use the reaction, that is the regeneration reaction. The regeneration reaction is CaZe plus 2NaCl giving me Na2Ze plus CaCl2. CaZe is my calcium zeolite plus 2NaCl giving me Na2Ze. Na2Ze is my sodium zeolite plus CaCl2. Let us see the balancing of the same. The calcium over here is 1 on the reactant side. Calcium on the product side is also 1. Zeolite is 1 on the reactant side. Zeolite on the product side is also 1. Then we have 2NaCl, that means 2 sodiums on the reactant side. We also have 2 sodiums on the product side. And 2 chlorines on the reactant side, giving me Cl2, that is 2 chlorines on the product side. This is my entire regeneration reaction. And it's a balanced reaction. And that is the reason why when you look at it, you will find out that 2NaCl is corresponding to 1 CaCl2, which will eventually correspond to 1 CaCO3. Now, why have we used CaCO3 over here? Because whenever we have to calculate the hardness of any sample, while calculating it, we have to make sure that we have the CaCO3 equivalence over there. That is 2 into 58.5. Now, 58.5 is the molecular weight of NaCl, which will correspond to 111. Now this 111 is the molecular weight of CaCl2, which will correspond to the 100 grams of CaCO3, and this 100 corresponds to the molecular weight of CaCO3. Now quantity of NaCl is regeneration. That is 125 into 200 will correspond to 25,000 grams of NaCl. Thus 2 into 58.5 grams of NaCl will correspond to 100 grams. So how much will 25,000 grams will correspond to? Again, this is my cross equation over here. Cross multiplication will be done as 25,000 into 100 divided by 2 into 58.5. So 25,000 into 100 upon 2 into 58.5. When you calculate this, you get it as 21367 grams of CaCO3, and when you convert this into milligrams, you get 21360000 milligrams of CaCO3. This is my hardness of water. So in today's session, we studied about the zeolite process. We solved problems based on zeolite process and how we can use the regeneration reaction for it. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.